give a brief update about the status of the pulp project. So this year has been a year of a lot of releases. So after several years of announcements, this year we actually released the whole our platform course and FPGA implementation. So basically, the initial goal, research goal of the PULP project was to develop an application, a low power parallel application for the Internet of Things. The main goal is to process data coming from very low power sensors such as inertial memory units, microphones, low power imagers, but also biomedical sensors with very low power. Typically, in this kind of near sensor processing systems, we have a very low power MCU, usually implemented with Cortex-M kind of microcontrollers, which process a little bit of the data before transmissions with low bandwidth or high bandwidth protocols, wireless protocols. The problem of this kind of systems is that as long as you cannot process on the edge the data, you need to transmit a lot of data. And the contribution of the wireless transmission to the overall power consumption of the system becomes dominant. So the goal of our project is to improve the computing capabilities of the processing system, still keeping the whole power consumption of a system in a few milliwatt power envelope. If we look into the market and into the applications, we have several kind of applications domains. So we have application where we want to read temperature sensors or pressure sensors and transmit the data wirelessly. So for this kind of applications, there is no problem because we don't need to make any kind of processing. We can just take the data every minute and transmit it wirelessly with a very low power and low performance microcontroller. But as long as the bandwidth of the sensor increases and the complexity of the near sensor data analytic algorithms increases, we need to use more complex and more powerful processors. So the problem with commercially available processors is that it is possible to increase the computing power of processor, but at a cost of a much higher power. For example, we have very low power implementations of Cortex-M0 processors, which consumes just few milliwatt, but as soon as we go to high-end class of microcontrollers, such as STM32, for example, the power envelope of the system goes up to a few hundred of milliwatts. So the goal of the PULP project is to provide a parallel computing platform to solve this kind of problem. And the two key concepts that we leverage from research viewpoint is parallel near-threshold computing. So increase the parallelism to improve the performance of our system, but keep the supply voltage of the system at low voltage to improve the energy efficiency. The other concept that we want to leverage in this project is open sourcing. We tried to leverage open source hardware and possible as much as possible to create a community around this project. And of course, we have programming models for our platform, virtualization layers such as real-time operating systems, compiler infrastructure based on GCC or LVM, and processor and hardware IPs, which are the main focus of this presentation. Of course, the low-power silicon technology is not part of the open-source portfolio, but we believed that if we wanted to create this big community around this project, we needed to demonstrate our concepts also in hardware. That's why we have implemented several prototypes of our chips in the last 5 years. And for what concerns the hardware license we are using for the processor and hardware IPs, we are trying to use a very permissive license, which is the Solder Pad license. Basically, every company or university or whoever can take our IPs and do whatever they want with the IPs, even not disclosing or saying that they are using these IPs. So since the project started 5 years ago, but we made the first release of our IPs in 2016, when we released our first Palpino platform, and mainly because of stability of the platform and this kind of thing. But starting from this year, all our IPs, software and hardware IPs, and the platforms and the infrastructure reached a maturity that was, we believed, enough to be open sourced to the rest of the world. So starting from February, we have delivered and released open source more complex platforms, such as Palpissimo, which is a 32-bit microcontroller, Ariane, which is a 64-bit core. And in March, we released OpenPulp, which is our multiple core cluster, the SDK and virtual platform, that are the software tools which are required to run applications, debug application, and simulate application based on our system. And last week, actually a couple of days ago, we released also Hero, which is multi-cluster research platform of our system. And in the meantime, we have good back contributions from several companies, such as Hembe, Cosmo, Lorisk, Micron, in terms of software infrastructure, porting of DSP libraries, and verification. So in the PULP architecture, we have several components. We have, first of all, the RISC-V cores, a set of peripherals, interconnects, but also full platforms and hardware accelerators that can be used in a domain-specific application to accelerate specific kernels. The most common kernels are convolutional neural network now. So for example, we have examples of application accelerators for convolutional neural networks. Starting from the cores, we have four different cores in our platform. Three are 32-bit cores and one is a 64-bit core. So the first kind of cores are the very low-cost core, zero risky, which is implementing the RISC-V 32 specification with the integer, compressed, and multiplication option. The micro RISC-V is implementing the compressed instruction with the reduced register file, 16-bit. Then we have our, let's say, main 32-bit core optimized for energy efficient digital signal processing, which implements the IEC and M extensions from RISC-V, plus proprietary extensions from our PULP developments that include single instruction, multiple data extensions, hardware loops, bit manipulation instruction, optimization for fixed points. And we have also a floating point unit that can be added to this core to deal with application requiring very highly dynamic applications with the requirement of a floating point unit. And finally, we have the Ariane core, which implements the ICM extension of the RISC-V 64-bit ISA. So, as highlighted before, our RISC-V is a four-stage pipeline core optimized for energy efficiency. And this core is basically the core which run the DSP applications in our processing cluster. The core is around 40 kilogate. And the logic depth is around 30 logic elements, and it features 3.19 core mark per megahertz. And as highlighted before, this core includes several digital signal processing extensions that makes it suitable for elaboration of data coming from multiple sensors, both fixed point and the floating point. Then we have the two area optimized core, the zero risky and the micro risky. So basically the main difference, these are only two stage pipeline cores, so they can be used as controllers, so in all kinds of applications that doesn't require heavy processing. And these cores are used also as controllers for the I/O in our multiprocessor system. I will show an example later. And we have the zero risky and the micro risky. The zero risky is a 19 kilogate core, which has the support for multiplication and it features a 32-bit register file, while the micro risky is the very basic version of our RISC-V cores that is 12 kilogate and it works on a 16-bit register file without a multiplier. Finally, one of the latest release this year was the Ariane core. This processor is tuned for high frequency, is a six-stage pipeline processor with an integrated cache. It has in-order issuer, out-of-order write-back, and in-order commit, and it supports the privileged instruction set specification of RISC-V, including machine mode, supervisor mode, and user mode, and it is suitable for virtualized memory access since it includes hardware page table worker. We implemented this processor in two different technologies and it can work up to 910 megahertz in worst case condition in a 22 nanometer technology node from GlobalFoundries. So an FPGA implementation of the Ariane core is available on the Xilinx Vertex 7. And on this target, it operates in an operating frequency range between 50 and 100 megahertz. But this is not really the target. So the FPGA implementation is not really the target of this core. So we have optimized it mainly for ASIC implementation. And it consumes 15 kiloluts logic element of the FPGA. And it boots Linux, and everything here you see is open source, and you can download it, including the bitstream and the commands to implement this on FPGA and boot Linux. But to implement complex systems, we don't need only core. So we have also a lot of other IPs available in our repository. So we have peripherals such as ZTAG, SPI, UART, I2S, but also DMA and GPIO. And we have the interconnects that are needed to make this core communicate with the memory subsystem, with the peripherals and so on. So we have a proprietary logarithmic interconnect, an APB peripheral bus, and an AXI4 interconnect. In terms of platform, I talked about Palpino. So Palpino is our first single core platform we released a few years ago. And it's a very basic platform featuring a RISC-V core that can be configured to be risky, zero risky, or micro risky, and an AX interconnect that communicates to an APB bus and a few peripherals. This year we improved a lot this architecture, including a new shared memory subsystem that allows to the peripherals and the core to communicate to the memory with much higher bandwidth. So typically in microcontrollers we have this bandwidth bottleneck to the memory, to the SRAM, because the access to the SRAM is limited to be 32-bit. We have implemented this interconnect, the green interconnect you see here, basically. And in this way, you can have a parallel access to the L2 memory banks. In addition, we have added this microDMA subsystem that allows all the peripherals available in the platform. So we have UART, SPI, I2C, I2S, SDIO, and also a camera interface to communicate with very high bandwidth, let's say the maximum bandwidth allowed by the periphery, with the memory banks. And the processor can offload all the memory transfers to this DMA to perform very efficient transfers. And in addition, we have these hardware accelerators that can be plugged directly to the logarithmic interconnect and act as initiator of this interconnect, so they can process data directly on the interconnect. And we have also online available an example of this hardware accelerator, so you can download it from our Git repository and see how it works and how to modify it to create your own hardware accelerator and customize it. For what concerns the Ariane processor, we have also a SoC supporting this processor. While in the low power domain, so the main goal of our platform, what we open sourced a few months ago is basically our latest version of Mr. Wolf, which is a full SoC implementing on the left side the Palpissimo architecture, so all the SoC infrastructure, which includes the processor, the peripheral, power management, and access to the L2 memory bank, and a parallel accelerator based on our powerful RISC-V cores. So this is basically the most advanced architecture we developed so far, and it includes eight RISC-V cores with shared FPU and DMA to transfer data from the L1 memory to the L2 memory of the rest of the SoC. We implemented this system in TSMC 40 nanometer technology, and we packaged this with a 64-pin QFN package. As I already say, this cluster includes eight RISC-V cores, two shared floating point units for energy efficient floating point computation and 64 bytes of TCDM. While on the SoC, we have also integrated power management such as DC-DC converter and the capability to implement a state retentive L2 memory. So all the SoC can go in deep sleep and it can be waken up, and when the chip is waken up, the L2 memory retain the state that it has before the sleep. And now we are using this chip for several of our applications I was mentioning before. So we have this prototype and we are creating a lot of boards and application, especially on the vision system, low power vision systems, and biomedical system. Last but not least, this year has been released the commercial version of the PULP system, which is commercialized by GreenWaves Technology. There has been a training on the GAP8 processor this morning, and it has been mentioned also in previous presentations. So this is a commercial version of the PULP system, and you can download, you can order the GAPUINO boards if you're interested in them from the website of GreenWaves Technology. Finally, the latest release is the release of our heterogeneous system for high-performance computing, which is called HERO, this final stock. This SoC includes several clusters, and it is implemented on a Xilinx Zynq FPGA, where the ARM host communicates with the parallel processor clusters using a shared memory paradigm. So basically, when using OpenMP primitives, you can create the wall program, and you can offload the different parts of computation to the parallel cluster. So to conclude, in the last few years, we had, especially in the last year, we have a very great feedback from the industrial community. So there are a lot of industries and also research centers using our IPs, in some cases implementing our IPs in their product, in some cases using these IPs to make trials of tools and technologies such as Mentor Graphic, Cadence, and ST Microelectronics. And a lot of other industries are evaluating these IPs. So that's all for today. I hope it was not too long. Do you have any questions?
Yeah, questions. I can yell.
Two questions. Easy question. Do you have a CoreMark score for Ariane? And the second question is there a fully open version of a Pulpissimo system with an exemplary accelerator that's available as well? Sort of, is there a open source version of GAP8 that can be kind of inspected and looked into and played with?
Okay, so the first question, I don't remember the CoreMark per megahertz of Ariane, but Ariane is still under development, let's say. It's not very high. For the question about Pulpissimo, yes, Pulpissimo is available open source, and also Pulp, we have an open source version of the world Pulp with Pulpissimo plus the parallel cluster, but this is not exactly the version which has been taped out in GAP8. Of course, in GAP8 they made their own customization and optimization to target their specific application domain. But if you go to pulpplatform.org, there is a link to our Git repository, and there you can download Pulpissimo, and there is one software example that uses the hardware accelerator. The hardware accelerator is just a very stupid example. It's a Mac accelerator, but it can be used as a vehicle to design more complex accelerators.
I've got a question. What's the status of your debug unit? Because you've had a debug unit way before anyone thought about standardizing it, and consequently it's not the same as the standard debug unit. Where are you going with debug units?
Yeah, it's still the same. we have not improved it a lot. On Ariane, yeah.
Is now compatible.
Yeah, in Ariane we have a debug unit compatible with the RISC-V specifications.
Excellent.
But it has not been ported yet to the other systems. Thank you. Bye.